travel out of town for work, you know how stressful it can be getting your kids ready, especially when they miss you. And Debbie Karlstrand from the Family Conservancy Center is here with some help. Good to see you.
Good to see you, too.
A lot of parents travel. They fly to different places. Sometimes it's mom, sometimes it's dad, sometimes it's both.
Right.
And that can be really stressful.
It can, and so preparation is really key. Mm-hmm. So as soon as you know you're going out of town, begin planning for who will be responsible for your children, gathering the things that they'll need for school and extracurricular activities, and making sure you're having a conversation with your children that you will be leaving. And you have to be real careful with that because you don't want to tell them too soon to where they worry for a long amount of time, but you also want them to have time to prepare and ask you any questions they may have.
You say let them know how long you'll be gone. Why is that important?
Because they need to know how long that's going to be. Mm-hmm. And for some children, their sense of time, mm-hmm. depending on their developmental level, can be very difficult.
We used to say three sleeps.
Yeah, exactly. Three sleeps. Or like if, when you're talking to them about your departure, making this ring chain so they can rip one off for each day.
So hold
they
that
know.
Up. Let's get that on
so
camera.
So they know how many days it'll be until you'll
All right,
be
so
home.
So if you're going to go 4 days.
Yes.
Then you'll say, okay, three more days until daddy's back.
Yeah.
Two more days until mom's back.
Exactly. And that's just a way. Or if you could write them little special notes every day and you can write on there how many days till you're home. But just so they have a sense of when you're coming back. And you really have to be careful about your departure. Children typically do better if it is at home in a time that's really calm, not when you're rushed. But you say your goodbyes, you make them meaningful,
and then depart. Don't take them to the airport with you. So there's leg hugging and crying and gnashing of teeth.
And that's really hard for children, and it's really hard for parents too. So really kind of plan out your departure thoughtfully. And really make sure your children have the same routines. Mm-hmm. And if you read them a nighttime story every night, maybe you could record yourself reading it to them, or you could even do it over the internet, like by Skyping or FaceTiming. So your child could even, you could even take the same copy of the book with you in your suitcase and look at the pages together. But that's
a
way
that
your children really feel.
Cow jumping over the moon.
Yes. And find different ways to communicate. With older children, a lot of texting or phone calls. But the important thing to remember as a parent, if you say you're going to call or you say you're going to text or you're going to see each other over internet together, you follow through with that. It really is important to children that you follow through with those promises that you make. And when you return, spend some meaningful time together and let them have something that they're going to look forward to.
Important. Don't come in the phone. Come in the house from a trip and you're on your phone talking to somebody.
Exactly.
Make them feel important.
Exactly. And maybe they can have a special activity that you're going to do when you get home so they have something to look forward to.
Cool. Great ideas. I love it. For more